Live via satellite from the Sports Arena on the campus of Pratt Community College in Pratt, Kansas, it's the 35th annual Miss Kansas Scholarship Pageant, sponsored by the Pratt JCs, with LaTanya Hall, Jack Ewing, Garth Gardner, the current reigning Miss Kansas, Candace K. Pyle, Master of Ceremonies Roger Cornish, and television hostess Mary Lofton. Principal performers, Miss Colorado 1987 and third runner-up to Miss America, LaTanya Hall. From Pratt Community College here in Pratt, Jack Ewing. In his debut at Miss Kansas, from Ashland, Kansas, Garth Gardner. And of course, our reigning Miss Kansas, Candace K. Pyle.
Tonight's my night. That's right.
Good evening once again. In the next 2 hours, we'll be picking a young lady not only to represent this state at the Miss America pageant in September in Atlantic City, but to represent Kansas all over the nation during the next year. Miss America 1989. The selection process begins tonight with picking our 10 semifinalists to be announced not in numerical or alphabetical order, but the order in which they'll appear in swimsuit, evening gown, and talent competition. Our first of tonight's 10 semifinalists, contestant number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Don Nelson. Contestant number 1, Miss KU Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb. Contestant number 2, Miss Capital City Topeka, Nikki Weigel. Contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Contestant number 4, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. Contestant number 23, Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Lynn Hedrick. Contestant number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa Lynette Griffith. Contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. Contestant number 6, Miss Frontier, Ronelle Erickson. And contestant number 24, Miss Wichita, Melissa Marche Hedick. Now a hand for all 10 of tonight's semifinalists. And as they prepare for tonight's swimsuit competition, let's meet our panel of 5 distinguished judges. They've had a very difficult job to do this week, and that job becomes even more difficult tonight. First of all, Ken Berry. Born and educated in England, Ken has been actively involved with the Miss America pageant for 42 years. He's a member of the board of directors for the Miss New York State Scholarship Pageant and has judged on both the state and local levels. Please welcome Mr. Ken Berry. Jackie Del Genio, an interior designer and buyer for a major Chicago furniture company, serves as wardrobe chairman for the Miss Illinois pageant, as well as being a training staff member, an interview coach, and talent coordinator. And she's also judged numerous pageants. Let's welcome Jackie Del Genio. Susan Eby's involvement with the Miss America program covers the past 20 years. She's emceed, produced, judged, and directed both local and state pageants. And she's been executive producer of Miss Idaho for 7 years and is a consultant with a management services company in Beverly Hills. Please welcome Susan Eby. Doris E. Hamm is a former member of the Miss Florida Board of Directors and has been traveling companion for Miss Florida the past 3 years and chairperson of the Hostess and Housing Committee for 7 years. Let's welcome Doris E. Hamm. And Michael Paul McMahon, the owner of McMahon Aviation Incorporated and executive director of the Miss Louisiana pageant the past 2 years. He was also director of production for 6 years and has been on the grooming committee for Miss Louisiana. Please welcome Michael Paul McMahon. And now a hand for all 5 of our judges. We're honored by your presence here tonight. We're also honored to once again be introducing to you our current Miss Kansas 1988, Candace K. Pyle.
Thank you. Welcome to all of you joining us on the statewide Miss Kansas Network. I'm Mary Loftus, and I'll be your television hostess this evening. There's plenty of excitement ahead as the Miss Kansas pageant celebrates its 35th anniversary right here in Pratt. The swimsuit competition is ahead. The 10 semifinalists are changing for that right now, and we'll bring that to you. But first, here's a look at some of the preliminary talent competition from the past two nights.
College Auditorium. It's time for the 1989 Miss Kansas Swimsuit Competition. Our first contestant, number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Dawn Nelson. Michelle is the daughter of Joanne Nelson, a 1988 graduate of Independence High School. She'll be a sophomore at Washburn University, majoring in communications. Michelle's hobbies include impressionistic art and doll collecting. And in sport, she takes part in fencing, bicycling, aerobics, and weightlifting. Contestant number one, Miss KU Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb. Peggy is the daughter of William and Marilyn Cobb, a 1986 graduate of Southeast High School in Wichita, and she'll be a senior at the University of Kansas, majoring in broadcast sales. Her hobbies include photography, filmmaking, bowling, walking, and country music. And sports-wise, she also enjoys, in addition to bowling, she likes softball. Contestant number two, Miss Capital City Topeka, Nikki Weigel. Nikki's the daughter of Robert and Carol Weigel, a 1984 graduate of Winfield High School. She'll be a senior this fall at the University of Kansas, majoring in elementary and middle education. In her spare time, she enjoys teaching pom-pom clinics for young children and listening to music. And the sports she enjoys include aerobics and running. Now contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Amy is the daughter of Barry and Debbie Hyatt, a 1988 graduate of Colby High School, and she'll be a sophomore this fall at Kansas State University, majoring in communications and psychology. Amy's hobbies include playing piano, singing, reading, counted cross-stitching, and designing clothing. And the sports she enjoys include volleyball, running, swimming, and tennis. Contestant number four, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. Kim is the daughter of Paul and Marilyn Duggar, a 1986 graduate of Bethel Life High School, And she'll be a senior at Friends University, majoring in music performance. Her hobbies include singing, songwriting, playing the piano, working out, cooking, and traveling. Contestant number 23, Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Lynn Hedrick. Jennifer is the daughter of Kent and Mary Cochran and Phil Hedrick, a 1985 graduate of Wellington High School, and she'll be a senior this fall at the Wichita State University, majoring in political science. Her hobbies include walking, weightlifting, reading, shopping, and attending sporting events. And also in sports, she enjoys taking part in tennis, golf, swimming, and snow skiing. Contestant number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa Lynette Griffith. Melissa is the daughter of John and Phyllis Griffith, a 1987 graduate of Mays High School, and she'll be a junior at Oklahoma City University, majoring in piano performance. In her spare time, Melissa enjoys aerobics, jogging, and collecting ornaments. Contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. Stacia is the daughter of Robin and Karen Foley, a 1985 graduate of Cape and Mount Carmel High School in Wichita, and she'll be a senior at the Wichita State University this fall, majoring in graphic design. Her hobbies include being a freelance designer, painting, piano, and singing. And in sports, she enjoys tennis, golf, aerobics, swimming, and skiing. Contestant number 6, Miss Frontier, Ranelle Erickson. Ranelle is the daughter of Ronald and Marlene Erickson, a 1985 graduate of Decatur Community High School, and was also a 1989 graduate of the Wichita State University. There she majored in business management. Hobbies include reading, walking, cooking, and window shopping. And in sports, she enjoys volleyball and tennis. Contestant number 24, Miss Wichita, Melissa Marche Hennick. Melissa is the daughter of Thomas and Nancy Hennick, a 1986 graduate of Wichita Southeast High School. This fall, she'll be a senior at the Wichita State University, majoring in speech communication and radio, TV, film. Hobbies include pencil drawing, counted cross stitch, and collecting elephants. In sports, she enjoys baseball, aerobics, and walking. And now a hand for our 10 semifinalists in swimsuit.
That wraps up the swimsuit competition. Just ahead from our stage here in Pratt, the talent competition, a key element in the judging, and one I'm sure you'll agree it's a lot of fun to watch. Now, while our semifinalists get ready for the first of the talent competition tonight, we're going to look at some you won't be seeing on stage this evening.
Boy, go mad, go, but not like a yo-yo school boy.
Just play it cool, boy. Real cool.
And welcome back to Pratt. It's time to begin the talent portion of the 1989 Miss Kansas Scholarship Pageant. First of all, contestant number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Don Nelson. Faux Follet, a French impressionistic song, describes the pale flame shining inside the jack-o'-lantern. Written by the French piano virtuoso Isidore Philippe, the piece is a dazzling display of technical brilliance and hauntingly beautiful melody. Contestant number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Don Nelson. Contestant number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Don Nelson. Our next performer is contestant number 1, Miss KU Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb. We're now going to enter into the sultry sound of the blues. Often the blues deal with the desire for love. Peggy Cobb has some advice in this matter. Don't settle for anything less than a Sunday kind of love. Contestant number 1, Miss KU Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb.
I want a Sunday kind. can grow so cold. I need a love for all my life to have and to hold. I want a Sunday kind of love. Oh, yeah. I don't want a Monday or a Tuesday, a Wednesday.
Contestant number one, Miss K.U. Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb. Contestant number two is Miss Capital City Topeka, Nikki Weigel. One may most often see Nikki performing at Kansas Jayhawk basketball or football games as a Kansas Crimson girl. However, tonight she'll dance in a somewhat different style as she entertains you with an interpretive ballet to the overture from Funny Girl. Contestant number two, Nikki Weigel.
Again, you know, the 10 semifinalists have all performed their talent for the judges in preliminary competition, but regardless of how well they did in the first round, they must be in top form tonight in order to score well. We'll be back with more talent performances, but first, here's a look at more of the preliminary talent competition from Thursday and Friday nights. Take a look.
Pageant.
Time to continue the talent portion of our evening. Next contestant, number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Music is the universal language of the world. Through it, love, anger, hope, pain, the entire spectrum of human emotions can be expressed. Amy Hyatt will perform a classical piano solo entitled Toccata by Aram Khachaturian. Contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Next up is contestant number 4, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. Love can be experienced in many forms. Expressing her love for performing with the classic Love is Where You Find It is contestant number 4, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar.
Take a chance now, what a romance now.
Contestant number four, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. Contestant number 23 is Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Lynn Hedrick. The very word Carmen recalls Spain, the fiery cigarette girl, her love affair with Don Jose, the dragon corporal, and Esquivel, the bullfighter. Jennifer Hedrick recreates the setting of George Bizet's dramatic, powerful opera as she plays an excerpt from Fantasy Brilliance, Themes from Carmen. Contestant number 23, Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Lynn Hedrick.
I'm sure, based on just what you've seen so far, you'll agree the judges have a tough job judging this talent competition. And it only gets worse because there are four more performances coming after this break. But first, we're going to take another look at some of the highlights from the preliminary nights of talent competition. And there were many. It's really a shame you can't see all the performances. Here are a few of them.
My dad was crying. I had never seen my dad cry before. I didn't even know dads could cry. Somehow his shaking shoulders just didn't seem as big now.
Tonight's 1989 Miss Kansas competition. The next contestant, number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa L. Griffith. Creating images with the piano was the innovation of the famous French composer Claude Debussy. Tonight, Melissa Griffith will pour her heart and soul into a piece entitled Pour Le Piano. Contestant number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa Griffith. Contestant number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa L. Griffiths. Contestant number 17 is Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. The stage is set, or it soon will be. The microphone is in place, and center stage Miss Bel Air, performing the Star Search version of the immortal Julie Garland classic, Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. Contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. Contestant number 6, Miss Frontier, Ranelle Erickson. When you sit down to watch TV, do you always know what you're going to watch? Television, the media we've all grown up with, from the black and white sets to today's modern remote control. Flipping through the channels of some of our favorites, here is contestant number 6 as she performs an arrangement by Chuck Dodson titled Remote Control Medley. Miss Frontier, Ranelle Erickson. That's contestant number 6, Miss Frontier, Renelle Erickson. Next, contestant number 24, Miss Wichita, Melissa Hedick. Will the next talent be acrobatics, or will it be jazz? Or perhaps acrobatics and jazz? That got you hooked yet? Contestant number 24, Miss Wichita, Melissa Hedick. Wichita, Melissa Hedick, contestant number 24. How about a hand for all of our talent contestants tonight?
Wow. Well, that brings us to the end of the talent performances. The girls are changing now for the evening gown competition. It's also during this segment of the program that they'll be asked to give a short response to a question from the judges. Certainly one of the more glamorous events of the evening, so you want to stay with us for that. But first, we're going to take another look at some of the preliminary talent competition from the past two nights.
Welcome back to Pratt Community Junior College in the 1989 Miss Kansas Scholarship Pageant. Please welcome once again Miss Colorado 1987 and third runner-up to Miss America, LaTanya Hall.
Thank you. Thank God for you. When beneath
LaTanya Hall back for the second straight year, and we are thrilled to have her here with us in Pratt. It's time now to meet our contestants in evening gown. And again, a change in this year's show. In the elimination of the speech given by each contestant in the evening gown competition this year, in accordance with the rules of the Miss America pageant, the contestants will be asked a live interview question. Contestant number 20 in the Southeast Kansas, Michelle Dawn Nelson. Michelle, what is the best part of competing for the title of Miss Kansas?
The best part to me of competing for the title of Miss Kansas is the experience of getting on stage and being able to perform. The business that I'm going into is communications, and any chance that I get to be in front of a live crowd will help me tremendously for my future.
Michelle is 6 feet tall, weighs 135 pounds, with brown hair and brown eyes. In high school, she was a member of the National Honor Society and president of the National Forensics League. In college, she was selected an outstanding freshman and also made the president's honor roll. She wants to become account executive for a major advertising firm and eventually run for the U.S. Senate. Contestant number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Dawn Nelson. Contestant number one, Miss K.U. Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb. Peggy, describe a true friend.
A true friend is someone who is always loyal, someone who will be with you through every moment, and most importantly, someone who can make you laugh.
Peggy is 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighs 110 pounds, with blonde hair and gray eyes. In high school, she was a state scholar, a Kansas Board of Regents scholar, won the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, and the Emporia State President's Award of Excellence. In college, a member of the Golden Key National Honor Society. She hopes to work as a sales manager for a major network affiliate and also be a successful wife and mother. Contestant number one, Miss K.U. Lawrence, Peggy Diane Cobb. Contestant number two, Miss Capital City Topeka, Nikki Weigel. Nikki, how do you describe a gentleman?
I have one sitting in the crowd, Roger. And he's everything to me. He's kind, he's considerate, and he's always after my best interest. And I love him.
Nikki is 5 feet 2 inches tall, weighs 105 pounds, with blonde hair and hazel eyes. She was Kansas Miss Teen 1983, also homecoming queen and on the honor roll in high school. In college, co-captain of the Kansas Crimson Girls and sorority social chairman for 2 years. After getting her master's, she plans to teach grade school or middle school. Contestant number two, Miss Capital City Topeka, Nikki Weigel. Contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Amy, who is the most influential person in the world today and why?
I think right now the most influential person in the world is Mikhail Gorbachev. I think his ideas of change and progress are a welcome change in today's world. And I think you'll see a brand new tomorrow and an exciting future for the entire world.
Amy is 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighs 128 pounds, with brown hair and brown eyes. She was a National Honor Society member in high school, Board of Regents State of Kansas Scholar Award winner, in college, KSU Leadership Award, and a semi-finalist in the KSU Speech Contest. After receiving her major in mass communications and psychology, she wants to be successful in her career, family life, and as a member of society. Contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. Contestant number 4, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. Kimberly, how would your best friend describe you?
My best friend would describe me, first of all, as a person who cares about other people and as a person who enjoys life and wants to experience it to the fullest and who also has a sense of humor.
Kimberly is 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighs 112 pounds, with blonde hair and blue eyes. In high school, she's been a valedictorian and a member of 5 National Honor Societies. In college, she's had the lead roles in musicals, a member of 2 National Honor Societies, on the President's Honor Roll, and a varsity cheerleader. After college graduation, she'll pursue a career as a professional singer and actress. Contestant number 4, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. Contestant number 23, Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Lynn Hedrick. Jennifer, can women truly have a dual career role as a professional and mother?
Certainly, I believe so. I think that it is very important nowadays that women both have a career and are also able to experience the role of, as a mother, because both can be very rewarding.
Jennifer is 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighs 110 pounds, with brown hair and brown eyes. She was named a Kansas Honor Scholar in high school and a winner of the National Band Achievement Award. She was on Wichita State's Dean's Honor Roll and served as a 1987 legislative intern for the Kansas House of Representatives. She wants to practice law in a large corporate law firm and run for political office. Contestant number 23, Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Lynn Hedrick. Contestant number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa Lynette Griffith. Melissa, what are your aspirations 10 years from now?
10 years from now, I hope to have a successful career in vocal music education, elementary, and also have a rewarding family and time to spend both with both.
Melissa is 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighs 118 pounds, with auburn hair and blue eyes. She was the John Schneider Memorial Piano Scholarship Award winner in high school, also a member of the Kansas Honor Scholar, Foster Music Outstanding Player Award. In college, she received numerous scholarships from Oklahoma City University, Wichita State, K-State, and the University of Kansas. She wants to become a vital part of a national advertising agency in the creative department. Contestant number 13, Miss Center City, Melissa Lynette Griffith. Contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. Stacia, if you could interview President Bush, what single question would you most like to ask?
I would ask President Bush, Mr. Bush, would you please get more judges and help our judicial system? Thank you.
Stacia is 5 feet 4 and a half inches tall, weighs 105 pounds, with auburn hair and brown eyes. a National Scholastic Art Awards winner each year for 4 years in high school, National Honor Society member, and named among the who's who of America high school students. She's been a junior varsity cheerleader and a member of chamber singers and a cappella choir at WSU. She plans to graduate with a degree in graphic design and begin a professional career in her own graphic design studio. Contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Ann Foley. Contestant number 6, Miss Frontier, Ranel Erickson. Ranel, if you could have dinner with anyone, who would you choose and why?
I would choose my family. We do not get to spend enough time together as it is, and I think that would be a very good meal.
Ranel is 5 feet 6.5 inches tall, 112 pounds, with blonde hair and blue eyes. She was valedictorian of her high school class, a homecoming queen, Arion Music Award winner, in college a presidential scholar and student ambassador. She's done television and radio commercials and is a Special Olympics volunteer. Contestant number 6, Miss Frontier, Ranel Erickson. Contestant number 24, Miss Wichita, Melissa Marche Hedick. Melissa, what have you gained from this week's pageant experience?
I feel I've gained many things, including many friendships, and which that is very important to me. A friend that you can trust, that you can tell anything to, and you can really believe in them. And I feel that's the most I've gained this week.
Melissa is 5 feet 5 inches tall, 105 pounds, with blonde hair and blue eyes. In high school, she was named in the Who's Who of American Students Council and a cheerleader for 4 years. A member of the Spirit Squad National Champions in college and picked as an outstanding citizen of Wichita. In the immediate future, she'd like to be involved in the production of local television programming with long-term aspirations of producing national films. Contestant number 24, Miss Wichita, Melissa Marche Hedick. And now a hand for all of our contestants this evening in evening gown. It's indeed a pleasure to welcome back Mr. Garth Gardner and Miss Kansas 1988, Candace Pyle.
Sometimes it takes too much. together. Lost time,
it's better late than never.
Lost time.
Garth Gardner, Candace Pyle, it's sort of a bittersweet time for us because it's time to once again say goodbye to a young lady we've come to know and love in the last year. Our last chance to tell Candace Pyle how much we care about her. Candace K. Pyle, Miss Kansas, 1988.
Special and sentimental moment as the crowd here in the auditorium says goodbye to Candace K. Pyle. But before us still, a very big moment, the big moment of the evening, the moment in which you will see the new Miss Kansas crown. But here again, as we pause for this break, a look at some of the preliminary talent competition from Thursday and Friday night.
Just die? You don't die without me dying too.
I can't care what they come in here and say. They said your father died. January 1986, a new year. But I don't want anything new. I want us all back together again. Shouldn't the worst have been over months ago?
No bad news.
on, bring me. Don't bring me now, bed.
Moments almost here. We first of all have some very special awards. The Jack Ewing Gymnastics Award. We have in fact five special awards to present, together with two new awards sponsored by the Fruit of the Loom Company and Sheer Indulgence Hosiery, both national sponsors of the Miss America program. They are presented to the young ladies who, in the eyes of our judges, excel in their respective fields. The Margene Savage Award, given to an outstanding vocalist in memory of the late Margene Savage, Miss Kansas, 1954. A recipient of the Margene Savage Award, contestant number four, Miss Butler County, Kim Duggar. The Deborah Dean Barnes Award is in honor of Kansas' second Miss America for performance of an outstanding instrumentalist. The winner of the Deborah Dean Barnes Award, contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. The Deborah Bryant Award is in honor of Kansas' first Miss America and is awarded to the contestant who, in the opinion of the judges, was outstanding in the talent field. The Deborah Bryant Award goes to contestant number five, Miss Emporia, Kim Smith. The Outstanding Interview Award, a $250 scholarship sponsored by Taylor Printing Incorporated and presented to contestant number 20, Miss Southeast Kansas, Michelle Nelson. The Outstanding Dramatic or Dance Presentation Award, a $250 scholarship sponsored by the Scott and Hodges Company, presented to contestant number 26, Miss Northeast Kansas, Rhonda Sutton. Now it's my privilege to present the new Quality of Life Scholarship Award. That's brought to us by Fruit of the Loom, a new major sponsor of the Miss America pageant. The Fruit of the Loom Quality of Life Award will be presented to one winner from each state, as well as a winner from the national pageant in Atlantic City. These women have been selected because they've made significant contributions to improving the quality of life in their community through involvement in civic or charitable projects, and the winner of a $500 scholarship check, a good size check, $500 on behalf of Fruit of the Loom, contestant number 15, Miss Greater Kansas City, Deborah McWhorter. We will get her a real check a little bit later on. Continuing in that same theme, on behalf of national sponsor Sheer Indulgence Hosiery, I'd like to announce that tonight's winner will receive a $1,000 Sheer Indulgence Confidence Scholarship. Each of the 51 state winners will get such a scholarship, recognizing that successful women, like Miss Kansas, pursue their goals with confidence. So congratulations from Sheer Indulgence. It's time now to announce our runners-up. And Miss Kansas, 1989. And Candace, if you would get the envelope from our judges, please. How about a hand for all of our contestants while she's doing that? We begin with fourth runner-up. Our fourth runner-up, contestant number 2, Miss Capital City Topeka, Nicolette Weigel. Now, our third runner-up, contestant number 17, Miss Bel Air, Stacia Foley. Our second runner-up, contestant number 25, Miss Troya Thomas County, Amy Hyatt. First runner-up, a very important announcement, because if for any reason Miss Kansas cannot fulfill her duties during the coming year, our first runner-up will step in as Miss Kansas for 1989. Our first runner-up, contestant number 4, Miss Butler County Community College, Kimberly K. Duggar. And now the moment has arrived to name Miss Kansas 1989. And the winner is contestant number 23, Miss Queen of the Prairie, Jennifer Hedrick. To be crowned by Governor Mike Hayden.
She positively glows. She walks of Miss America.
Thank you to our home audience. Thank you here in the Pratt Auditorium. We'll see you again next year. Good night.